Namaste YouTube, welcome to Cafe Enoma and welcome to our diamond reaction for Rhapsody. This is gonna be one hour reaction for Rhapsody, or you call Rhapsody of Fire, and it is for their song Gargoyles, Angels of Darkness. This is from their album Power of the Dragon Flame, which was released in the year 2002. This is just an excerpt that was given by a patron. That's all we know about this song.
Yes. It's good that we know only that much, because in a reaction of this length and this kind, I would like to keep it as honest, as unbiased, and as a pure reaction. So what we know is that the title of the song is Gargoyles, Angels of Darkness. And we know that the album is Power of the Dragon Flame. That is what the thumbnail also shows over here. The thumbnail shows a lot of fascinating things. There's the valleys below.
Yeah.
The greenery you can see is filled with lush greenery. There are the, you can't really call them mountains, but they seem like canyons. They seem like hills, you know. And there are a lot of these creatures, you know, flying creatures. They
dragons, yeah.
Yeah, they'll definitely look like dragons, but there's a lot of white in them. I like the fact that white is used on this album cover for the wings, which kind of gives them an angelic appearance, in my opinion. But though their claws are very big, you know, especially one of them towards the bottom of the picture. So it's a very interesting scenario portrayed here in the album cover. The songs is Gargoyles, and I'll come to Kirti about this because perhaps she has some insight to share about this particular topic. Gargoyles, Angels of Darkness. What can you say about these things called gargoyles?
I'm sure people must be knowing the meaning of gargoyles. Gargoyles are those scary faces. The scary, you know, scriptures that are sculpted to put right on top of your house, which can be seen from far off, anybody coming, passing by, everybody should be able to see it, to scare off the evil eyes of other people, to keep negative and evil energies away from the house. Gargoyles also was used, even, you know, in the current times, gargoyles, those, you know, small pieces of it are made, handmade in Japan, or, you know, made in bulk, and people like to put them on their houses, on top, right on top of their, you know, old style houses, Japanese houses. And it's got kind of the tiger face that rest of Asia shares, the typical tiger face with a big jawline, or, you know, whatever you call that, that face on it. It has to look very, very scary. The gargoyle face has to look scary for the negative person to be scared of, right, you know, from far itself. And gargoyles were used also to outlet water, drain the terrace water, or whatever you call rain water that gets collected on the roof, should go out through the mouth, the tongue,
yeah,
long tongue.
Looks very beautiful. You know, you're talking only about Japan. If you go to South Mumbai, where I've been born and I was raised for the first 12 years of my life, we have plenty of such
gargoyles.
Structures. Yeah, gargoyles as well as similar structures all over South Mumbai.
Right.
In fact, even if you go today to the town area, right from the Victoria Terminus, which is called Chhatrapati Shivaji Terminus, one of our greatest kings in Maharashtra,
yes.
Historical figures. If you go to the Chhatrapati Shivaji Terminus,
yes,
you'll find gargoyles hanging out from arcs, certain ends of the top structures. You'll find lions which have very, very, you know, very, very fierce looks in their eyes and the way they're constructed. If you go walk down that road, down all the way to Flora Fountain, you will find a lot of the buildings, the historical structures in Mumbai, in South Mumbai, that have a lot of gargoyles towards the top. And there are a lot of these high beam buildings in South Mumbai. And most of them on the top towards the roof have gargoyles. So it's not something only in Japan. It is prevalent, I'm assuming, from the British times.
Yeah.
Because that's when most of those buildings were constructed, those monuments even. So you will find them all across India, especially where the French were there, where the Britishers were there. And if I'm not mistaken, the word gargoyle itself is French.
It's a French
word. So there's a lot of influence of that in the southern part of India, where the French colonies are existing till today. You have fountains there, you have monuments there which have gargoyles. And yes, the purpose of a gargoyle is primarily to ward off evil spirits. But let's not stop there. We are going to go deep into this reaction to highlight certain things which possibly no one else can on this platform and in the world. With our experience of counseling must shine, our experience of history of our great country, India must shine. You must want to visit India, you must want to visit the places talked about in this song. That is the priority. You must want to listen to the song itself plenty of times. But that is of course an honest reaction. So if you do not like the song, definitely I am not one who's going to say I don't, you know, I'm going to keep quiet. I'm definitely going to say I was bored, I did not like it, and I'll also add why. That is the difference between us and many others out there, that we are not hesitant to say we do not like something or this wasn't as good as expected, but we'll definitely back it up with sound reasons why we thought so. So similarly, this is what is going to happen in this reaction. We're going to try and isolate certain key parts of the song. We have never heard it before, so we could not do research about which parts to isolate. But I do have an idea in my mind based on what I've heard of Rhapsody thus far. So Kirti and me will both be trying to isolate and focus on certain key instruments or key aspects of the song. So we will try and analyze them from our own perspective, a fresh, refreshing, pure perspective. Kirti is known to be a pure reactor. This is what she's well known for. So we'll try and do that too. Now, if you talk about gargoyles, it's not just the French, the British, the Japanese that have them. It's the Italians. Rhapsody is an Italian band. We must not forget.
Yes.
And if you see the Italian monuments, many of the great art of Italy, though many were highly spiritual sculptors and artists who came out of Italy, there were also some who dug deep into the dark side. They literally dug deep into the dark side. So if you dig deep into the history of Italy and if you go around Rome, you will actually see a lot of the gargoyles still there today in the monuments and places. And this I know not by being there. I have not yet been to Rome or other parts of Italy where that is still present. But I've seen it in abundance on television and TV guides and YouTube to guides, travelogues, etc. You know, it's very, very common. You look up any of the guides, you know, Rick Steve comes to mind. You watch his guides to Europe and specifically Italy, you'll see exactly what I'm talking about. So the gargoyles are associated with evil. Even though they ward off evil, they are the godfathers of evil. So this is what I want to tell you right away. This is my understanding of a gargoyle. It is not just something that wards off evil. Historically, it is always put at the top or deep down in the dungeons and caves, sculpted there. Even in Indian history, there are plenty of such gargoyles. So it is the godfathers of evil, in other words, the angels of darkness. So what a beautiful title this song has. Angels of darkness, preceding it, the most important word, gargoyles, angels of darkness. On this note, I guess it is time to start this reaction. Since I've given an elaborate introduction to this one, I will ask Kirti to focus on the lyrics and the music, give a pure reaction for at least 10-15 minutes so that you all get a good idea about her opinion on it, focusing on a lot of key areas of the song. Perhaps she could dig deeper into the history of gargoyles. Perhaps she could talk about it with reference to Hindu scriptures, whatever she knows, which she does know a lot more than I do, and most people do. So let's see what she can share in her own words, though, not going deep into the scriptures and things like that, because no one really has a time for the deep intricacies of scriptures over here. So this is, I'm assuming, is going to be something which is the evil of evil. On that note, it's time to get started. It's going to be epic, I can tell. and I hope it lives up to the expectations that I have for this song and I have for the patron who has requested it.
Yes.
Kai, one of our earliest patrons who's been with us for more than 6 months now, and it's always an honor and always exciting to react to the songs. But do keep in mind, out of the both of us, I'm gonna be critical in this one. So if I see something I don't like, and if I see something I like, I'm going to really talk a lot about it. Let's get started, Kirti. Thank you.
Let's go!
The powerful energies of the furthest secret cosmos heard so the prayer of our mother Gaia, the supreme spirit who gave us the miracle of life, and her dark sun breathed new life. The power of the dragon flame was realizing what had seemed to be impossible.
And easy send if we can all the legendary tale. All the one who found the light and the dragon flame inside. All the tragic grain, all the thousand flames of the
happening. It happened. Dargor mortally struck the Queen of the Dead and called the mighty gargoyles against the legions of darkness. He pushed Akron into the hands of the Nordic warrior. Now a dying victim of terrible tortures, the chosen one let himself fall into the deep marshes constraining the Black King. With the emerald sword again in his hands, not to move, they became food for the snakes of the abyss. But this sacrifice had a terrific and great effect, and Akron's death meant the victory on the evil forces of abyss. Once, forever.
Wow.
Remember, proud brothers, everything is possible when you let the mystic power of the dragon flame burn in your heart. believe it. It's the dragon flame.
Wow. One of the things I would love to do is to put this on my bucket list to make a movie out of this. You know, this would be a perfect movie, a fantasy fiction movie, call it what you will. It was very spiritual for me.
Okay.
What are your thoughts, Kirti, first up?
You know, first up, I felt we were sitting in a theater or in an auditorium where this was played. The sound effect, everything was as if we were specially there. It's just that we couldn't have the visuals, otherwise it would have made it like we were actually watching a movie or a musical. The way this was arranged, the way it goes. You know, last time one of the songs, I don't remember which one exactly. Not the Symphony of Enchanted Land, but either it was Emerald Sword or the other one, where I felt the power metal part should have been reduced or not come. But here the balance of the whole thing, all the music that was coming, the multi-layered music that was put, I don't have any complaints. Every bit of the song had its role and it played beautifully.
The music was masterly, it was brilliant, it was sublime, it was perfection. The way it started with the acoustic, with a very slow start.
Beautiful.
The infusion of the piano and the piano-like instruments on the synthesizer, done so beautifully in the middle and towards the end. The background sound effects added in at key moments in the song. The highlight for me, the main highlight, there are many. But the first and most important one was the Tenebra, Tenebra, Domina, Tenebra, Tenebra, Daname. That part sung by those wonderful female opera singers. Wow, whenever that would kick in, as well as the other opera singers' bits in the song, that was what made it so special to me. You have the acoustic guitar, you have the guitars which are connected to, of course, electricity. You have the piano, which is connected to electricity in the shape of a synthesizer where you can play other instruments. You have wonderful infusion of the male vocalist and the narration with a very great voice.
Oh, awesome. That was
of a male vocalist. Very beautifully done. It is such a long story. There are different parts to the story. On the screen, we could see that there are essentially three parts. You know, it all ended with the end. In the middle, there was that interlude, wonderful interlude, where things calmed down for a moment before they picked up steam again.
I know.
Everything was so beautifully connected. You know, everything right from the beginning, how the story started, how it grew. Then the, you know, the person who's called for this to fight, to go against, to rise against the evil force, the evil demon, the evil god, call it what you will, Satan, rise against, and then at the end it was all done. You know, you could literally see, imagine things at the end, that everything was being done. The work was being completed. It was the rise against the evil. What a title for the song. The gargoyles rise again as the angels of darkness. They go out there, they make it their call. Gargoyles fly, gargoyles rise. It was their calling. It was told to them, this is what they have to do. They went out there and did just that. They made sure that they conquered the evil forces and they made it peaceful and serene and beautiful at the end. Once again.
When you get the dragon flame within you, you have to use it. You have to embrace it and you have to use it. This is a mammoth production. The way the song is created, this is a gigantic piece made by Rhapsody. I only wish more, you know, a lot of people should enjoy this music. People should enjoy and appreciate this music. The kind of workforce that is put into this song, the kind of brains, the intelligence, the multi-layering, that's what I would call, multi-layered music that was on display in this song was off the charts. You don't get to hear this kind of music every now and then because it takes tremendous amount of brains, planning, execution, hard work, discipline to put something like this together in one piece.
Yeah, what we'll do right now is that we will go through the lyrics.
Yes, I want to read the
bit
lyrics.
By bit, and I will allow Kirti to give her take on it. As a first time pure listener, this is what everyone loves. I do not want to get too deep into the lyrics, but I will summarize things towards the end. My understanding of it from a counselor's, trainer's point of view, which I think will everyone will like, and which will connect with the song. But the lyrics we'll take up piece by piece now.
Yes.
And let's get started with it, Kirti. Part 1.
Okay.
Angeli di Petra Mystica. I think it
Angels
will probably...
Angels of Darkness, that's what I said.
Okay. The prophet told of loud thunders, quaking the surface of earth, when the black raven would have turned victim of wonderful spells. He would have become a white swan, born from the darklands of sin. Neither would Arisius have believed what was now changing in him. Swan, prince of the magic lake, Dargor is your name. Gargoyles fly, gargoyles rise, gargoyles fly high. Angeli di Pietra Mystica, Ladri di Anim Fira Volano. So this is the first part of it, Kirti.
Yeah.
What I think listeners will appreciate and what you can do very well as a first-time listener is explain it from what you understood of it. Rather than dig too deep into it, what did you understand from this? The first two verses and the first part of it.
I wanted to get to this one because I remember two birds being named right in the beginning by the prophet. But I, you know, couldn't remember apart from the swan what we were talking about, the other bird, when we went deeper into the song. So now I know it was the black raven and that turned into white swan. Because of some powers that came into him. This is a prophecy. And that prophecy, you know, shook earth. You know, with a thunder, with an earthquake it came. And these changes were happening to this black raven, which turned into white swan, and later I think this the same same bird is turning into the gargoyle. It's going to be their savior, or be the person, the thing that is going to fight against the evil. That's what I'm looking at the moment.
Okay.
Yeah.
Let's move on to the second part of this story and this song, this wonderful song.
They have called it Dargor, is your name.
Yeah. The second part goes like this, the third and fourth verse.
Yeah.
Another mess of vampires. Now this itself says a lot. Another mess of vampires. So there's a lot of chaos, there's a lot of mess.
A lot of
evil floating around the place. You know, whichever time or period this is being talked about, or which is the primary focus of this song, is a very dark period. So a lot of evil floating around, vampires, you know, bloodsuckers. Another mess of vampires, masquerade of sadistic pride. He could not endure these cruel games against him who once spared its life. The fourth verse now. He realized, so not too late, to be really far from his king. Far from his infinite bloodthirst, too far to call them right for him. Rise, fly high and steal his soul, angels of stone. This is the end of part one of the song.
Yes.
What are your thoughts on these two verses to end the first part of the song?
You know, as I already assume, there is lot of other forces, the dark forces that are rising, the cruel things that are coming against the people of the land, against the people who are now in danger, and the gargoyle is ready. It's got the dragon flame in it, the white swan that is ready to fly. But I think there is another character that we are talking about. If this song is part of their theme album, that must have been the earlier story who we are talking about right here. I don't think this we are talking about the swan or the gargoyle or Dargor. This is a character
My understanding of this is pretty simple.
Okay.
Suddenly after the first two verses, suddenly we see in this part of the story there is a bunch of vampires, a masquerade of sadistic pride, as it said. He could not really take it. You know, the principal character in the story.
Yes.
Could not take all this. You know, that line says it all. He could not endure these cruel games. Suddenly, he saw these vampires coming in to suck his blood, literally. A masquerade of sadistic pride against him who once spared its life.
He left them alive in the past when they last faced off. That's what I feel. When they last clashed with each other, I think he spared them, and now again they become
I think it's the other way around.
Oh.
They spared him.
Okay.
Yeah. He then, my understanding is, realized so not too late to be really far from his king, far from his infinite bloodthirst, too far to call them right for him. So this is like one of the challenges, the second level of the game, and this is one of the major challenges, the vampire level. Suddenly it was thrown at him like a surprise. If it's Doom, you know, a game that I knew very well in my younger days, suddenly things come in, you know, a new monster comes into the picture. So here there's a mess of vampires who are parading, masquerading with this sadistic pride, laughing and, you know, making life difficult for him. You know, hovering over him, hovering around him, making life really difficult and creepy and dangerous for him. Then it comes, you know, the last two lines explain everything towards the end. Rise, fly high and steal his soul, angels of stone. Then we have the best part of the song, in my opinion, the exotic interlude, which was the instrumental. What is your take on that? Do you remember much of it?
I
do remember the guitars coming in once again, it mellowing down. The piano, the synthesizer, a lot was coming in at that moment. And then the opera elements also kicked in once again.
There were moments in the song when the transition from the non-electrical pieces to the electrical pieces was beautifully performed. And you don't mind it here. The way it comes and the way it goes, entry and exit was so beautifully done. You know, they merged together. The Spanish guitar that starts the song, and after that followed by a little bit of operatic voice that, you know, comes right after it.
Yeah, this the opera
part,
voice.
Yeah, this part as well has the Spanish guitar and, you know, transition from all that, the traditional sounds to the metal, power metal sound was beautifully done. And of course, we have the opera singers singing the chorus again and again. They are, you know, in chorus, they are motivating the gargoyle, Dargor is the name. Yeah, Dargor, to fly and fly high. So I loved it. You know, it's a song where you are encouraging your savior to go and get the evil. And that's what I guess Gargoyle does. Quietly though.
Yeah. Let's move to the third part. Part 3 of the song.
Yeah.
This is the dot 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 part. And the legend ends.
And the legend
but
ends.
Interestingly, even after that, 3 more dots.
Uh-huh.
So perhaps it hasn't
there is
ended.
More. Yeah.
Part 3. I love when this
I
thing
like
happens.
This when Mother Gaia things came.
Okay. And the legend ends. I'll first read the part which is in the language which Rhapsody is famous for. Ti invoco o terra, colora il mio nero, con fiera lealtà io giro sincero, tra anni mort e caos immenso, a Gaia sovrana, l'amor più intenso, lo dorgar a te. Gargoyles, gargoyles, oh my brother gargoyles, rise now, rise for his soul. How did you like that, Kirti?
I like that.
This is part of our reaction and we can't ignore it.
No,
for someone who connects more with that language, you may not understand, but the fans of Rhapsody, who they make the music for,
yes,
most of them understand it.
Yes.
So if I ignore it, it's not, it's disrespecting them. Not about you here, is it?
No.
Dagar, do it. It must be done. Free your rage and light your soul. It's Gaia's call.
It
How
is
do you
land.
Like that?
I like that. The way you're doing it's getting dramatic.
Yeah,
and
it's
it is
pretty late at night in Mumbai, so
I know.
We'll have to. I hope our neighbors don't complain.
You know, now it's coming together. The land, the Gaia, is also pleading for Gargoyle to go up there, rise, take the lead, and, you know, get your the ragiest rage out of you.
Oh.
If that makes sense.
Then dot 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 again. The powerful energies of the furthest secret cosmos heard the prayer of our mother Gaia, the supreme spirit who gave us the miracle of life, and her dark sun breathed new life. The power of the dragon flame was realizing what had seemed to be impossible. This is the first mention of the powerful dragon flame. The dragon flame that came in at the end, the fag end of this wonderful, amazing song, which ended it all so beautifully. And then you add those background sound effects towards the end. What is your take on this verse before I move to the next one?
They are talking about now, you know, the gargoyle is feeling the spirit in him. He can feel the power that has come to him. He can feel even the Mother Earth. The Gaia is also saying the same thing like the people on it. So this is high time, you know. I have to take all this energy that is around me, in me, and take a lead.
Yeah, I love that. What seemed to be impossible, suddenly it had become possible. The dragon flame rising. You know,
I love the voice.
Wow.
Who did that narration.
You don't like my voice?
No, I like yours too. I'm saying the way it came very dramatically in the music. As if, you know, someone was talking about the start of the earth, how it happened.
Very well sung. Very well
very
sung
well.
By Rhapsody. This really deserves some kind of an award for the music.
It should, yeah.
For the composition. It is new age music for me. I don't think it's right to
it
only
is, yeah.
categorize them as symphonic power metal. I think this really
they
is.
They have much more elements
than
that too.
They have a lot more. It's new age. It's
yeah.
music that I listen to every day. New age music. Because there too, there are so many layers. There are so many elements. Specifically with, you know, kitaro. You must listen to Kitaro Kai to know what I'm talking about, as well as Yanni. Pick their best, pick their worst, but I'm sure you'll get what I mean. And there is no worse for these two. And then, continuing, and this is then the epic end of the legendary tale of the one who found the light and the dragon flame inside, of the tragic reign of 1,000 flames, of the town's defenders who face real pain, of symphonies of enchanted land, of whispers of love and hate. What is your understanding of this verse?
First of all, I love the piece when, love the line when it came, symphonies of enchanted lands. Yeah, I could connect with it. And later on, it is going to also portray Emerald Sword as well. So it's connecting from the past to this album. The lines, just to tell people, you know, we have that too. And maybe the story continues from there to this one.
Let's not connect those kind of things. No.
We don't know.
Here what I can see is very plain and simple. I'll add it in because you're going off topic again and again.
Sorry.
Comparing it to earlier songs.
No, I know I'm not it's comparing. The same. I'm just
we,
saying.
We don't know. We don't know. No. This is a story by itself. Why would you want to compare with something else?
Right.
For me, it is a complete story because here is the epic end. This is the end of the tale. The dragon flame is there inside. The tragic reign of 1,000 flames. The symphonies of enchanted land, whispers of love and hate. Whispers.
I think it is the time when the face-off has started. The battle has started.
The dawn of victory can breathe in the wind, and this would mean the great rebirth. Reborn the ones who's giving his life. The towns lying on the ground. Be one of us, and act as all the prophecies want. To mountain and valleys, to fire and snow, to sun, moon and wisdom, rise your soul. It's the call.
Okay, I'll say what it means.
Yeah.
Thank you. Now when the battle is on between the gargoyle and those masses of masquerades of those, what are they?
Messy vampires.
Vampires. Now the fight is on, and the appeal, the request is from all the elements on earth to come together to fight against it. Everything on earth, mountains, valleys, fire, snow, sun, moon, everything, all the elements put together to come together in this fight, and we shall win.
Actually, this is what everything wants.
Yeah.
All the forces of Mother Nature want the victory of this principal character. Oh no! Oh God! Oh God, no! What is happening? Angeli di Pietra Mistica, Ladri di Anim Fiera Volano. Angeli di Pietra Mistica, Ladri di Anim Fiera Volano. Oh God! My God! It happened. Evil happened. Oh, what is your understanding of this?
Something is going wrong. I think something is going wrong.
Not what was expected. Suddenly there's another surprise.
Sudden twist.
And let's see. Maybe we'll try to figure it out with this.
No. I can see that.
I think this is one of the penultimate verses.
Yeah.
Dargor mortally struck the queen of the dead and called the mighty gargoyles against the legions of darkness. He pushed Akron into the hands of the Nordic warrior, now a dying victim of terrible tortures. The chosen one let himself fall into the deep marshes, constraining the Black King with the emerald sword against his hands, again in his hands, not to move. They became soon food for the slimy snakes of the abyss. But this sacrifice had a terrific and great effect, and Akron's death meant the victory on the evil forces of Abyss. So finally it's Akron's death. It means the victory on the evil forces of the Abyss. What is your understanding of this, though, Kirti?
Something has gone wrong, you know, a move of Dargor went wrong. I think now I'm a bit confused. Not knowing the whole picture. Right now, he's made a move that is killed a very important person from their side. And it's a small victory on the other side. Akron seems to be from this side, who's by mistake, was hurled into problem, and he's been eaten by snakes of the abyss.
There are few things that stand out for me, that's what I'm really good at doing when it comes to a lot of text. Dargor struck the queen of the dead mortally, so she's dead.
She's dead.
Then called the mighty gargoyles,
yes,
against the legions of darkness.
Yes.
And then another thing he did, he pushed Akron into the hands of the Nordic warrior. So another great thing happened over here.
Hmm.
Now the dying victim of terrible tortures. Suddenly he was also constraining the Black King with the Emerald Sword again in his hands.
Hmm.
This became food for the slimy snakes of the abyss. This sacrifice that happened, which the slimy snakes of the abyss were enjoying, had a terrific and great effect. Akron's death meant the victory on the evil forces of the abyss. Nothing has gone wrong. Everything has gone right. And once forever, the final line in that verse.
You know what happened? I think only because they are feeding on him, maybe they'll get a little bit power. But things are going right even till so far.
Yeah. So basically, what is your take on that, on everything so far, Kirti?
So far, the fight is in its prime moment. It's a win it or lose it moment. It's make it or break it. Now, the final few lines will tell us what exactly happened. But as of now, I think it's still in a better shape.
Remember, proud brothers, everything is possible when you let the mystic power of the dragon flame burn in your heart. Believe it, it's the dragon flame. Then comes that part again. Tenebra, tenebra, domina. Tenebra, tenebra, dharame. Let me see his face. Furiasieka, kaosinme, demone. Lead me to your horn beast named King. I will call my fire, air, earth, the ocean's waters to stop Inferno's breath. Tenebra, tenebra, domina. Tenebra, tenebra, danima. Tenebra, librame. What is your take on this, Kirti?
I think he's gone to the king of the evil. And he's willing to now put everything together and fight with him. This is going to be the last, face-off. Their leader, their king, he's reached the, deepest, most place among the evil. And now he's ready to take on him. And all the elements, all the forces of earth are helping him do that.
Yeah, so that was the song by RHAPSODY.
Yeah. Yeah.
Gargoyles, Angels of Darkness. So, to sum it up in the end, it is basically a fight of good against evil.
Yes.
We all know this by now. With Kirti's elaborate explanation as a pure reactor on this platform, obviously, it has come clear. Yes, it's the first listen. There will be some chaos, some confusion.
I know.
Just as in the story. But in the end, when you put it all together, it is the victory of good over evil.
Yes.
And who doesn't love a happy ending? Who doesn't love a victorious ending when the good is victorious over the evil forces on the planet? Today, all around us in the world, we have similar evil forces. Let's take a bug in a system. Let's take a troll on this platform.
Yes.
A troll who constantly comes on our reaction channel, hits the dislike button, not just with one ID, but sometimes two IDs or even three different IDs. Hits the dislike button with furious force. Dislike. So, hits a dislike button, tries to annoy us,
Yeah.
We, on the other hand, have our own thing going. We are getting better and better with more and more support, more and more success, more and more confidence.
And focus.
We are getting better and better. We are just in our own zone. Those one or two dislikes, those three dislikes that we are getting from the same person are spurring us to greater heights. It is giving us more and more energy, more and more motivation. It's us, the good reactors on this platform. Perhaps the only good reactors on YouTube, I may add,
mm-hmm.
who react to music like this honestly, passionately, as you saw, losing my voice in the process.
I know you have.
But I will still do my job. So there comes that troll into the system right now. This reaction has been published and the troll came with one idea and dislike button. And then left to his miserable corner of this planet. Left, sat there in his loneliness. Sat weaving his next move. His next move with his mental retardation and everything else that he's got is to come back, hit the dislike button again. Then he goes back to his miserable corner of the world, weaves more things, tries to make things a mess for us, just like this song. Tries to do things to chop us into little tiny bits and feed us to the slimy snakes in the abyss of this platform, to feed the other trolls that exist who creep and come find their way to Cafe Enoma on YouTube. And then, what do we do next? It comes to the point where we just get so sublime in the way we react to music that all the other people who are watching the reaction start realizing we cannot leave without hitting that like button.
Yes.
They realize that there's one person, one evil person in that miserable corner of this planet who's creating havoc in the first few minutes of a reaction like this being uploaded, who has no idea of Rhapsody, who has no idea of Gargoyles, who has no idea of the angels of darkness.
Every day.
But itself is like a gargoyle and an angel in the darkness. Why it's an angel? Because it makes us better. Everyone rises, all subscribers, all patrons, they get motivated to support us more. And literally, it's reverse psychology at its best. The good against evil. That is what this song was about. An example of what this song stands for in a little way in the world of today, the world of YouTube for us and for you who is watching this video on YouTube. Wow, this was such a great song. Final thoughts, Kirti, what do you have to say?
Yeah, if Rhapsody made a song concerning about today's life, talking about the gargoyles and talking about the mess of vampires that are hidden every corner of this world, which is a lot. Here we are seeing still a fewer of them. They can be in the eyesight. They can be in the where the land you can see. Right now, we can't even see them. They are hidden. They are creeping all over the place. They are literally stuck in every nook and corner and every house and every apartment, every building, every street, every road, every country. There are so many of them. Multiplied infestation of these vampires is happening. The vampires that only breed in the night, only breed in the darkness. They never want to come out openly with their faces and show that this is what I stand for and this is what I'm going to do to the world. This is what I'm going to do to the people. Whether it's a shooter, whether it's a terrorist, whether it's a troll, whether it's a person who's igniting passions in them. You know, even the person even more hidden and underneath, just like the king must have been. Inside the caves and in the deep core of earth. You have to go inside, passing all of these people to catch their neck. That is happening. I guess, you know, if Rhapsody comes out with another song, they should make on the current scenario with all this awesome and great music. I think that will connect with people worldwide. It will strike a chord with people worldwide. If they take up a topic which is current, the kings and queens and all that era is now over. And people don't get the message. they still think it is fantasy we are thinking. This is not fantasy. If you read between the lines, if you dig deeper, this is not fantasy. It was reality then, it will be reality now. It is still going on, we just have to change the names.
Yeah, what I would suggest if I was, you know, someone on the creative team of RHAPSODY or other bands that Kai requests quite often, what I would suggest to them is keep it real, because it's something that is
so
should be
music,
evergreen,
yeah.
relevant. Such fabulous music. If it was about a social issue such as bullying, build a story about that. You know, at the end, the person who's bullied wins over the bullies, makes things right, is never bullied again. Make it that. Make it a Shawshank Redemption-like story. Make it a Forrest Gump-like story. Make it a Green Mile-like story. Make it a Gladiator-like story. But make it relevant to today's world. Take a serious issue like bullying. Take a serious issue like rape. Take a serious issue like kidnapping, you know, and make it your own, because you can do that.
You can.
You have the skills to write so well. You have the skills to create phenomenal music.
So
why not create a song which is relevant to millions of people all over the world? Don't just make a song that is relevant to people who love history or who are from a particular part of the world, who likes stories of kings and queens. That is a minuscule part of the population, and it's sad because I've never heard about RHAPSODY before, and perhaps that is because I have no interest in listening to music of kings and queens, you know. So kings, queens and gargoyles and things like that, it's not of my interest. I do like ghosts and spirits. I have owned the world's largest ghost story site for close to 10 years before I sold off more than 70% of the stories to someone who was deeply interested in them. But, you know, even then, in my daily life, I'm not really interested with something which is not connected to me. So I would say, as a reactor, as a counselor, as a teacher with more than 25 years experience behind me, I would say, please make songs that are relevant to everybody. You know, it's a difficult task, I know. But take the example that I gave you.
It's no difficulty with this kind of talent.
It could be a suicide bomber, and how the suicide bomber ultimately blows up himself or herself and no one else dies. Make a song about that. That he tried to kill hundreds of people with him, but somehow someone came, had an instinct and got all those people out of there.
A gargoyle came and saved him.
Yeah, that is more relevant to me, because this is what I face in my country and when I go through the news. Make an issue of a person who's planning a big shooting, but then that is foiled because the moment he steps out of his door, he trips and falls, and he falls onto his head and he dies. Make a song like that, that before he went out of his garage even with his car, he died. That is relevant because people love to know about that. So anyway, that's it for me.
That's hard-hitting. We need something that is, with the powerful music like this, we need hard-hitting lyrics that can, you know, strike a chord with everybody who's watching and listening.
This is no way a criticism of this song.
No, it's just...
It is just constructive feedback.
Yeah.
Loved it. We love the song. And
RHAPSODY,
I know you'll be watching this one. If you understood exactly what we just said, I hope you enjoyed it and I hope you take it.
The kind of music RHAPSODY is making shouldn't be limited to.
And for the fans of RHAPSODY who sometimes are totally oblivious and ignorant to who we are, please take the time to visit our Patreon page to watch our intro video to learn more about us. There's a lot of effort and time that goes into a pure reaction like this one. It's not everyone's cup of tea. I literally can throw a challenge to any other reaction channel who can do it better than just what we did, and with the first time reaction. Goodbye. The link to our Patreon page where you can watch about us, learn about us, read about us is in the description box of this video, or you could directly type in patreon.com/ENOMA. patreon.com/Enoma.
Wow.
Namaste. Which basically means goodbye as well as hello. Welcome as well as farewell. In a very polite way.
Yes.